The elitist type mods certainly frown on us. They don't really like the idea of what we do to our scooters. But at the end of the day, that's us. You either love us or hate us. We ain't going to change for anybody.
I actually bought my first scooter, I think it was on my 25th birthday. That was in 1959. I was looking around for something to sort of get about on. I could never really afford a car, so I was looking around and I saw these scooter things. And I thought, that's for me.
I think it's special about a custom scooter because it shows your individuality. It's you. No one else has created it. You haven't been in a shop and bought it. You've built something that is what you wanted. You've designed it. You know every inch of the damn thing. An awful lot for me to part with this bike.
This is my Prozac thing. It's virtually the best legal drug you can buy, basically. I'd say out of all the bikes I've built, this is probably the one that I've managed to get the shape I actually wanted.
A lot of people don't like the fact that we cut down nice old original Italian scooters, paint them matte black, put bike forks in them. But at the end of the day,
we never cut down a scooter that didn't need cutting down, yeah. Basically.
That's my one. This is mine, but I've just recently bought it. It's one of Kev's efforts, but as as Kev is Kev, he gets bored with them and just goes on a new project.
It's got Kev's trademark on it
all over it. I mean, all this work here, this isn't normally on the frame. It's quite exciting to ride, as I've only done about 12 miles on it. nearly come off it. This one's quite a comfortable ride, basically, because it's got about 5 mil of padding on the seat. For those with fat asses, it's all right, like me, but I mean, you get someone who's got no ass, like Steve over there, look, he finds it really uncomfortable. I mean, he's cost a few hundred pounds, probably.
Well, sort of evolve over the years, don't
50
they?
50 pence.
£2.50.
Yeah, I mean, they've all evolved over years and years of just bits of other people's bikes, more or less. Yeah. I mean, it's all beg, steal and borrow from anyone else. That scooter there, look, that's ripe. Now that's at its time as a full frame scooter, and that needs. Is that yours, Kev? You just acquired it, mate.
That's
Greener's. Oh, is it? Yeah. See, that's living out its final lives, basically, as a.
It's done over 40,000 miles now. The frame's just about at it. The motor needs a rebuild.
Well, you know, it'll start slimming down. Got a diet.
We know to start dropping a few pounds.
Start losing bits off it.
How long you had that, mate?
That. What lot of that? Yeah, about 6 months. It's been written off once. That's why I had to put the tank in the middle. Stop the frame moving. Claire's nice chrome side panels on there, look.
I told you not to cut them down.
She said I could borrow them as long as I didn't cut them down, so I cut them down and paint them black.
Had to be done, really.
This chrome's for mods. Yeah, it's a bit of a survival bike. It's a wonder it still survived on the road. Only got two gears, first and fourth.
It's my baby and I love it.
It's a pig.
It is a pig.
All my working life I've always been in engineering.
This is a typical sort of workshop of someone who dabbles in these things like this. Everything's sort of cluttered up. You think I have problems working in here, but it's how I've always sort of worked when a little bit of a clutter. every so often I do have a blitz and clear things up. I mean, there's a little box of bits here, which as you can see, it's got Cento on it, which is, it's for a Cento scooter. A brake pedal, and it's all parts of, like, there's a petrol tank to go into this one, which is, you know, which is, I mean, as you can see, I paid £3 for that. See, that's another part there, which goes on there, which is what they call a horn casting. All these things, although they look rusty, you know, you can put a de-ruster on them and spray them on, no one will know the difference. What else? Then you get a pair of forks, which is probably going to go into that one. You've got your dampers there again with your forks, with your springs up inside there. It looks a load of rubbish, but stripping off with all paint and cleaning it all up, it can look as good as new. It's all rubbish to some people. It's a load of scrap, sort of rubbishy things, but to other people, it's all part of the scooter.
I often thought to myself, why have I never got married? I don't know. I don't really know. I suppose I've been married to my scooters, but I mean, I've got four sisters. I'm the only boy, and they've never, strange them, they've never been on to me. It was about time you got married. They've sort of just accepted me for what I am. I mean, I've never really had a serious girlfriend. No, I've got nothing against the girls. It's just never happened. I mean, there's lots of people in life. Things don't happen. You know, it's just what happens. I mean, I'm quite happy as I am. But who knows? Who knows? I might find a young lady or something to fight to get married. But at the moment, I'm quite happy as I am. All my friends are virtually scooterists, and they're. I haven't really got many friends outside the scootering scene, only like the family. I've got 12 scooters. I think it's 12, on my last count, but most of them are in pieces in me sort of shed in the garden, which now I'm sort of semi-retired. My idea is to sort of fully restore them all.
I keep seeing you, but I keep missing you. Oh,
this is my old scooter I bought new in 1961, and I had fitment, took it off the road about 72, 73, but prior to that I've done at least 100,000 miles on this old girl, and I thought it's about time I got it restored. And as you can see, I'm slowly doing it. Whether it's the right place to sort of restore one in your lounge, but I haven't got the little woman nagging me, you can't do it here, so consequently I've decided to do it in my lounge here.
I had a break from scooters for 33 years. All I was doing was working. Now, I suppose, reliving my youth. Your youth went past so quickly, you didn't appreciate it. It was just 100 miles an hour, that era. It was crazy. I was a mod, yeah. I just liked the way they dressed. I just thought they had style as opposed to rockers that were sort of all leather smothered in grease. I don't like being dirty. I bought my first suit from Burton's for 12 quid. I went to a youth club and with this suit on with a box jacket and Chelsea boots as used to have in those days. I walked in and I felt like King Kong in my 12 quid suit. It was fantastic. If a group of mods in the 60s had seen something like this, I don't think they would have liked it at all. It would not be what it was then. It was whilst everyone was proud of their bikes, it was nothing like this. They'd almost reject something like this.
In the 60s, you didn't see scooters like this. I mean, this isn't done as a 60s scooter. I did this to try and win a competition that I went in for, which I did win. But this isn't really what a 60s scooter was. I mean, all the lights and the mirrors and all the rest of it. But this scooter used to be white. you know, and we redid it like this.
The name Hardly Rideables came about to charge him up by Steve's dad. Steve and Simon, another club member, were building a Lambretta chop. Steve's dad come out. Steve said, "What do you think of my Hardly Davidson, Dad?" And Steve's dad basically turned around and said, "Looks more Hardly Rideable to me." And that was it. Kind of like a catchphrase was born, really.
We're not bikers, we're scooters. All the time we've been riding scooters, most of us have been following the trends and the music that go with scooters.
We look how we look purely out of practicality. You don't mind getting oil on a pair of Combats. You would if you had 80 quid jeans on. You don't mind wearing Dr. Martens because they keep your feet dry. They give you some ankle protection if you fall off. Doesn't matter how fast you're going, if you fall off a bike and you've got a pair of jeans on, it's going to hurt. Leathers will give you that bit of initial protection when you start sliding down the road on your bum. I think Brenda plays a very major part in Hardly Rideables, in as much that she has to put up with
you,
me and Reg and Steve out in the garage for hours, cutting bikes down, making loads of noise, walking mud and crap through the house.
Dirty handprints.
Every light switch in the house is surrounded by fingerprints.
Scooter parts in all rooms.
Using all the toilet roll. Well, half of those are yours.
I'd say Bria brings a little bit of sanity into the Hardly Rideables. She tends to help us keep things into perspective, don't you agree?
I just slap the odd bottom, don't I? Known each other for a long time now. They're all cuddly people, really.
You cook, we eat.
Yeah.
It's a club that does a mean curry.
There's absolutely nothing that any one of us here can do to a scooter that Bruna can't do to her own scooter. She's very, very, very technical-minded. I don't pretend to be the greatest scooter builder in the world, but when I get stuck, it can be a bit embarrassing. When your wife comes out and says, "Well, why not try plugging that wire in there?" and everything works perfectly. And I've been out there for 5 hours trying to figure it out.
I got out of going to rallies for a couple of years, and when I come back to like the scooter scene in 93, I was quite desperate to find someone to ride to a rally with, and I rang up loads of people. There was nobody going that I knew, so I got in contact with someone and said, "I'll come up with the Jailbirds," and we went to Margate, and that's when I first saw the first Hardly Rideable, and it was like, I've got to have one. It really sparked my interest in scooters again, you know, and building something different. I just had to have one.
It's still a scooter because it's still got small wheels and a scooter engine. It's quite comfortable, actually, once you're going.
You need long gangly legs.
You need long legs.
Arms.
And long arms. Your arse is a bit close to the ground. If you've got stumpy legs, you won't be able to change gear. And it does get a bit concerning when you're going past an Arctic or something, because it's your head's by the wheels. The turning circle on it is not an awful lot at all. So you can't do 3-point turns, you have to do like 23-point turns.
Club's got a couple of sort of like mottos, sayings. One of them, the best known one, is probably cut it down, paint it black.
Miller come up with a new one, because unfortunately we all like Star Trek. Restoration is futile. Chrome don't get your own. Matte black gets you back.
And the best place for chrome's in the bathroom.
Your first scooter is your first lab, I think. Places I've been on this, it's mind-boggling to what I've done and what I've done on it. So it'd be real great to jump on it again, bring back some happy memories. The countries I've visited, I think, have been Holland, Belgium, Germany, Austria, Italy, Switzerland, France. Oh, and Luxembourg. Last time I believe I rode this scooter, I can't do it an actual year, but I know it was in the early 70s, about 71, 72, when I decided to restore it. This one was my pride and joy, because it was, I bought new in 61. I've done in excess of 100,000 miles on this. I've got two or three more days to get it ready to go to the Isle of Wight. But hopefully, before the day's out, I'm hoping to have the engine running. All the signs are good that it should start. I think the money I spent on restoring the scooter, probably about £400 or £500, to restore a scooter, you've got to pay more for the bits and pieces than what the scooter was the value in them days. But the value of it now will have probably been in excess of £2,000. One of the biggest events of the calendar year is the Isle of Wight Scooter Rally, which happens on the August Bank Holiday weekend. It's basically Friday night, Saturday night, Sunday night, on to Monday morning. I'll definitely be going there this year. People do make a week's holiday of it.
Friday the 13th, the club's having a bit of a get-together, which has been billed as a matte black Friday the 13th, for obvious reasons. We've got some DJs coming down. We've hired a club in Camberley. Whether the night goes well or bad, as far as other people are concerned, we're going to have a good time.
I'm excited, anxious, dubious, and basically shitting myself because there's a lot of money riding on this. And plus, if we don't get the money back tonight, there's no way I'm going to the Isle of Wight. Should be initiated. Suspect is someone that wants to join our club, and if we think he's worthy of joining the club, we will actually let him in, depending on the public humiliation that this man could suffer. If he can go through the initiation test, and then it is whether or not he will join the club, depending on four members plus me. Tonight depends on whether
I'm wearing clean underpants.
Whether we can decide, me and four other members, whether he's worthy of wearing the t-shirt, which will entail
degradation of my personal character.
Yeah, could be total nudity.
You ain't getting that. That's deserved.
It could be dance of the flaming arseholes,
which, you ain't getting that either.
Which involves newspapers shoved up his arse and set light to. Yeah, total humiliation, probably on stage after the band. And there's a t-shirt waiting in the kiosk actually for this man. It all actually depends on the rest of the club.
I'll eat moths because there's a fucking number
on the rest of the club.
This bike started originally, it was imported from Italy, not in very good condition. I bought it off a guy called Steve from Harrow Hill. We completely restored it, and I wanted it white, which is what 160 GSs were originally. And we you know, put all the mod bits and pieces on it. And I went to a show, entered it for best mod scooter, and to my disappointment, I didn't win the prize.
The do is going really well. We've got people turned up we haven't seen in a very long time. We've got bikers turned up from Bournemouth, Helen and Budgie. The scooters turned up from Colchester, the scooters turned up from Wales, Birmingham. We made our money back, and that's all that we care about. We don't care, we're not breadheads, we ain't into making a vast fortune. We don't care about making a profit. All we care about is getting people in here to have a good time. We'll be right back.
everyone here for the Hardly Rideables. It's initiation time, folks. Are you ready?
Down. Trousers down, please.
Trousers down.
Just bear with us, folks.
Just bear with us, folks.
Round your knees. Round your knees.
Round your knees. Go on.
On your knees.
On your
knees.
Go on your knees. Come on.
Yeah, everybody give
him
a big cheer.
Come on, ready?
Put
a block in your own time, Andy.
No, you ain't
going to
get that.
Oh, come on.
In one,
two,
three,
four, five, six. Oh! Get him out of here. He's a Hardly Rideable.
That pie contains pigs, cystitis, pubic hair, arse chippings,
gonorrhea.
My piss may be nice, but my hemorrhoids cream is not.
When you travelled to Rome with the scooter club?
On his trip to Rome, we actually got the old Pope to come out and bless the scooters. Our scooter wouldn't start, which was unusual. It's always been a quite reliable one. And by the time I sussed out what it was and put a new plug or something, and I got going, I already found where else to speak the square, but as you went out driving en masse, I couldn't sort of get into where all the scooters were, and I didn't even see them. So consequently, my poor old scooter never got blessed.
Can someone justify spending so much money on a scooter? A difficult question. You might class it as wasting money. It gave me an awful lot of pleasure doing this bike, and other people entertain themselves in other ways. They might go on a holiday or do whatever. This gave me one hell of a lot of pleasure to do this bike, and it was therapeutic and you know, relaxing and everything. It was a joy to do. I love a challenge. I love a challenge. I love something to go for. And you know, I was new into the scooter era of today. When I went to this first show and saw some of the lovely scooters, I couldn't believe it. You know, some of the artwork and designs and engraving and everything, they are literally out of this world. And I was shocked. I thought, my God, I didn't know these existed. I could be, you know, riding around in a fair little car for what this has cost me, but a little car wouldn't have given me as much satisfaction as this has. Gary from Spray Point in Southend, I had this idea about the Union Jack and just letting it flow over the bike, and took the panels down to him and he spent all this time painting it. We then got it back and reassembled it, and lo and behold, the year had gone by, and away we go to the show again. And I was so damn nervous, it was unreal, because there's all these absolute superb scooters in there. They really were something else. And I'm thinking, Christ, if I don't win this. And it seemed to go on forever. And then the judging came, and they did it third, you know, second. And then all of a sudden they said, oh, the best mod scooter is Flag, which is the name they gave this bike. It was Scootering Magazine that called it Flag. I didn't know what to call it. And I was absolutely elated. I phoned my wife and said, I did it. Got the cup, and I achieved what I set out to achieve. It took Gary 162 hours to paint the bike, which was quite remarkable that, you know, he sort of didn't get bored doing it, but he certainly didn't. He took great pride, you know, in what he did, and, you know, was phoning me up every other day saying, how should we do this, how should we do that? And, you know, because he was obviously concerned about budget, you know, because 162 hours is not cheap. But once you saw the bike taking shape, you couldn't not do the next stage. It was crazy to say, this has cost a fortune so far and stop. You just have to finish it off. Airbrushing is, in my opinion, every bit as good as an artist working with a hand brush. Because he's working with a gun, with paint coming out of, and really and truly, to me that's harder than using a paintbrush. I would have loved to have gone to the Isle of Wight this year, but things didn't work out.
Motorcycle actually group to play a major part in letting people like us build these type of bikes, purely because government legislation would really rather we didn't build our own style of bikes, didn't lead the sort of lifestyle we do. To be honest, to ride something like this and to have it not legal is asking for trouble. They may look like piles of poo, but they're legal piles of poo.
Make sure they're legal. Basically we've been building them for years now. So you have to get them MOT'd every year, obviously. So you build it up, you take it for an MOT. If it doesn't pass an MOT, you know it's not legal for the road. You take it home, fix it, take it back again, passes, it passes.
Basically this weekend's on August Bank holiday. The Isle of Wight Scoot Rally. It's one of the biggest rallies of the year. And we decided we were going to come. For various reasons. And things ain't always going to plan. I'm really mightily pissed off, actually. The Isle of Wight's like 8 miles away, and it's taken us like 2 weeks to get this far. And I just want to go. Thank you.
Still haven't
beaten
my record for 8 hours yet.
But it's the weekend. I don't want to beat it. I can get back up with the police.
Fucking boat, I think.
Basically, the gear selector arm's snapped, which means that Mr. Miller here can't select gear. Not a problem if you carry the spares with you.
Hey? Just picked up a black cheese at the back in there.
Oh, sorry, just show you know, my engine's.
How was it? It's got a shit, it's alright. Yeah, it smells tart. Bitch.
Generally, we only get problems if we have a big group of people riding down for anything special.
On Vespers?
Well, it's not been major. I mean, like, mind you, we've still got 8 miles to go, so anything can happen in the next half hour.
I just want to.
It's been a long day.
It has been a very long day already.
You want some funny money?
Ah.
It's a good buzz today. Freaked out some straights. It's got to be done. Yeah? The media stereotype with scooters is that everybody is a mod. You know, it's apart from the 60s.
We ain't mods, we ain't scooters, we're hardly rideables.
Yeah. The island is now ours.
The island is ours. This weekend, we're going to take over the island. The island will be, by Monday, a nice shade of matte black, hopefully.
It'll be Isle of Black.
Isle of Black, yeah. Yeah. Look at them, there's fucking loads of ripe machines out there ready to cut down.
Yeah.
Loads of them.
And I only brought a junior hacksaw.
But it's nice to be here, now you ain't got to get back and, well, you haven't got to move for another couple of days, you know what I mean, instead to wander around finding beer and that, so, you know, it's cool. Yeah, Ivan and Baz, or Graham as his real name is, and Baz have come down from Scotland. Miller's come down from Rutland, so's Harold and Nob. That's nice. I mean, they broke the journey by coming down last night, but still a long way to come for a crack, isn't it?
When it come off?
I can't get the lid off the
crack. Sounds technical.
Yeah.
More bread?
Yeah, we'll have a little bit of bread.
That'll do.
Margarine as well.
No, we'll just have it neat. Have the bread. Break it a bit off. That's better.
Are you all the sausage you get on with? Or while we're making the meat?
No, it's all right, I'll eat my bread.
Home cooking, this is. Home cooking. To Les and Janet, that's Les and that's Janet. They live down in Hayward Heath.
We're not sure what do's we're going to go to at night, but it's definitely a ride out because that's the main thing really. It's the best thing to go out on really, a ride out.
It's 20 past 11. What did they do?
It's all right.
It's not right. Bad. Yeah, it's
bad
a good
a bit
night.
Of a boogie, ain't we?
Yeah, we've been up fucking dancing. That's what it's all about. Ride 400 miles to fucking get pissed, have a dance.
There's no really deep about it all. You just come here for a piss up, really.
That's
some people are
about.
A bit keen on it, but at the end of the day, it's just one big piss up, I hope.
You can hear the music to dance with without all the 150 decibels going into your ear. Because I think in this day and age, it's technically possible to have a silent disco. What everyone would have a little sort of radio in with headphones. So you go into a disco and there's no noise, but you see all these people jiggling about on the floor. You know, in this day and age, it is technically possible to do that.
Oh,
that would look something, wouldn't it?
You wouldn't have the brace pressure, would you? I mean, the bass drum pushing your chest in and out, so you save your heart from working.
Yeah.
Steve.
What?
Seems to be having a lot of trouble getting it fixed. Is that right?
Lots of trouble trying to get it fixed. It's a pile of shit. I'm going to go out and buy a fucking Honda Melody next week. Now I've lost the fucking spark plug.
What, that one there?
Not that one, the other one.
Oh!
Yeah, it's a Lambretta. It's more luck than fucking judgment.
Day five. Things ain't gone to plan.
Look, I'm trying not to be in a very good mood. You fuck off.
Oh, that's the picture, roll.
Custom shows aren't real life. Custom shows aren't bikes people use to work every day and back and then drive 500 miles at a weekend. That's what a lot of this scooter is about. The people that use their bikes day in, day out, no matter what the weather, they're the people, as far as I'm concerned, are real scooterists. And 1 year everybody's in the street races, next year everybody's in the chops, then somebody's in the restoring them. They get to the end of that and then they start all over again. Piece of piss to go to a shop and say, here's a blank check, build me a show winner. A lot of people do that.
Cheers, thanks a lot. Bye.
We don't build them to get a like £5 piece of plastic that somebody laughingly calls a trophy. You know, that's all, not what it's about for us. Half a dozen people taking a photograph's worth more than any piece of crap any bloody custom show judge can give you. It's rubbish. Custom shows are crap.
Custom paint job today, look, on that. 5 minutes. Custom paint job, you see. Gone from green to black. Looks much better.
And one easy lesson.
It used to be black.
It's even still gold.
Yes.
Plastic coat as well.
Yeah, that's it. I don't buy rubbish.
Oh, yeah. I'm a bit of Halfords man myself.
Mind you, I put too much petrol in the tank earlier and it all bubbled up. All painted.
Not to worry.
Made it look better. It looks better matte black. Yeah. It highlights it, doesn't it?
Yeah.
The matte black hides all the rust. Which, you know, I've been growing that rust for a long time. I've left it out. I've left it out in the rain for a couple of years and it was coming on good.
He's my mate and I love him, he's lovely, isn't he?
Wonderful one, Harold.
Yeah. How many other people do you know that sell you an engine that blows up within?
Nah.
And it's how far was it?
What's that?
How far did we get today?
The other day, you mean?
You slipped? Oh, yeah. About how far, wasn't it?
Yeah. Blech. It went backwards.
Put the plug back in, mate.
It's not further than this. It's not going to let me fucking forget that I sold him a BMW, is it? No fucking clue.
Put it in the
trunk
and it fucked up.
Oh,
you're
joking. Got a puncher fixed, no tyre on the bike. And I'm moseying on down to Heathrow. I've got this phone call. Oh, damn jobs that got all day. But the geezer can see people getting on his plane.
Oh, aren't you used to this kind of thing?
I know,
yeah. So often.
Especially a big guy after a while.
Yeah,
what did I fucking say to you? I said, is it
sparking just now? I want it, Paul.
No.
Have you got a P2 here? Coil?
Yeah.
Oh, can we try that? Just to try it.
Just try it.
Yeah?
Try
only if it's under your seat.
It's under the seat, yeah?
I didn't mean taking off your bonnet.
Come here to the Isle of Wight, meet everybody. Doesn't matter if you've got chops or cut downs, street racers, mod scooters, we'll all get along great. Have a good time, have a few drinks. Oh, it's just brilliant. It's such a great atmosphere to be in. Well, basically, it's a 1969 Lambretta GP 125DL. I've always enjoyed it. I've caught with my girlfriend on it, so it's a bit sentimental to me.
What is it you like the best about being here?
The dudes. The nightlife.
The sex.
Nothing to do with 60s mod at all. This is pure early 70s skinhead. So, that's definitely the thing I'm going for. I'm pleased with the look of it. It's a bit too slow, so I'll have to get a faster engine sorted out for next year.
fallings out when we first got together because...
Yeah, tell them that story.
He used to have a nice shiny black Vespa P200 and it had front carrier and
mirrors,
lights
all
and
over.
Mirrors and stuff
whip
like
aerials.
That. Oh, whip aerial and I am the face in pinstripe down one side and Gregor Bognum mods on the fly screen. It was just like, let's go downtown. I was like, I'm not going downtown for that.
And I got
I was like, no way, no way, somebody might see me.
I think it's the highlight of the weekend, all these thousands of scooters, all the blue flume of the smoke comes up of them, and it's great to see. And it created chaos on the road for about an hour.
Going on the ride out?
No.
Why not?
Should go home. No. I've had enough. We've had enough. We've had as much fun as we can get out of this rally now, and we're going to go home. And plus, we're boring bastards, really. We don't do ride outs.
Being a group of thousands to look good.
I think when you do get old, because say I'm now officially an old age pensioner, or senior citizen, whatever you call it, so mixing with people a lot younger than yourselves, it does give you a young outlook on life. So I highly recommend it. If when you get on a little bit years, try and mix with a lot of young people, so it gives you a good incentive to keep going. I reckon the scooter scene, because I'm saying there's lots and lots of young people in it, and I think that really keeps me young at heart. But what is a good thing on the scooter scene is you get lots of families come along there with their children. And I think that it keeps everyone young, and the children are sort of an influence on everything sort of ticking over nicely. I wasn't feeling 100% in my health, and I went to the old doctor, and through various tests they sent me to the hospital, and they suddenly discovered I had a tumour, and I was told that on Friday the 13th 1995, and I was in hospital in about 10 days, and they operated and obviously removed the tumour, but I think it was about 18 months before I thought I'm ready. So I dug the old scooter out, sort of give it a kicked it over and sort of re-oiled it and all that sort of thing. And I thought, I'm going, you know, and so I started driving again. You know, since then, I think it would have been about 90, through 96, through end of 96, I started driving again, and it felt good. touch wood, my health's been quite good over the last sort of 2 years. And long may it continue so I can keep scootering for many years to come.
I mean, if the world could be more open and get into scooters, they don't know what they're missing. Forget the rave scene, forget the dance scene. Get into the scooter scene. It's something else. It will change your life completely. It's fantastic.
On the last night on the Isle of Wight, to my utter delight and amazement, I was presented with a trophy for Scooters of the Decade. And, you know, I'm highly delighted with that. You know, it's something that I don't think anyone's ever had a trophy like this before. And to me, that was magic.
Our interest in scooters is a hobby. It's far beyond that. It's borderline obsession. It's 17 years of eating, drinking, sleeping, right, building, riding scooters.
It's a sad old cliche, but
it is a way of life.
A way of life.